लेसन नंबर 15 सम नेचुरल फिनोमिना। इन क्लास 7 यू रीड अबाउट विंड स्टॉर्म्स एंड साइक्लोन्स। यू लर्न दैट साइक्लोन कैन कॉज अ लॉट ऑफ डैमेज टू ह्यूमन लाइफ एंड प्रॉपर्टी। यू ऑल्सो लर्न दैट वी कैन प्रोटेक्ट अवर सेल्फ फ्रॉम दिस डिस्ट्रक्टिव फिनोमिना टू सम एक्सटेंट। इन दिस चैप्टर वी शैल डिस्कस टू अदर डिस्ट्रक्टिव नेचुरल फिनोमिना। दिस आर लाइटनिंग एंड अर्थक्वेक्स। वी शैल ऑल्सो डिस्कस What steps we can take to minimize destruction caused by this phenomena. 15.1 Lightning. You might have seen sparks on electric poles when wires become loose. This phenomena is quite common when wind is blowing and shaking the wires. You might also have seen sparks when a plug is loose in its socket. Lightning is also an electric spark, but on a huge scale. In ancient times, people did not understand the cause of these sparks. They were therefore afraid of lightning and thought that the wrath of gods was visiting them. Now, of course, we understand that lightning is caused by the accumulation of charges in the clouds. We need not to be afraid of lightning, but we have to take precautions to protect ourselves from the deadly sparks. The sparks that the Greeks knew about. The ancient Greeks knew as earlier as 600 BC, that's when amber was rubbed with fur. It attracted light objects such as hair. You might have seen that when you take off woolen or polyester clothes, your hands stand on ends. If you take off these clothes in the dark, you even see a spark and hear a crackling sound. In 1752, Benjamin Franklin, an American scientist, showed that lightning and the sparks from your clothes are essentially same phenomena. However, it took 2,000 years for this realization to occur. We shall now study some properties of electric charges. We shall also see how they are related to the lightning in the sky. Let us perform some activities to understand the nature of electric charges. But recall first what you might have played as a game. When you rub a plastic scale on your dry hair, the scale can attract very small piece of paper. 15.2 Charging by rubbing. Activity 15.1 Take a used ball pen refill and rub it vigorously with a piece of polythene. Bring it close to small pieces of paper. Take care not to touch the rubber end of the refill with your hand or with a metallic object. Repeat the activity with small pieces of dry leaf, husk and mustard seeds. Record your observations. When a plastic refill is rubbed with polythene, it acquires a small electric charge. Similarly, with a plastic comb is rubbed with dry hair, it acquires a small charge. These objects are called charged objects. In the process of charging, the refill and the plastic comb, polythene and hair also get charged. Let's try to charge some other objects that are familiar to you. 15.3 Types of charges and their interactions. We will select some objects from table 15.1 for the next activity. Acting 15.3 A. Inflate two balloons. Hang them in such a way that they do not touch each other. Rub both the balloons with a woolen cloth and release them. What do you observe? Now let us repeat this activity with the used pen refills. Rub one refill with polythene. Place it carefully in a glass tumbler using the tumbler as a stand. Rub the other end refill also with polythene. Bring it close to the charged refill. Be careful not to touch the charged end with your hand. Is there any effect on the refill in the tumbler? In this activity, you have brought close together the charged objects that were made of the same material. What happens if two charged objects made of different materials are brought close to each other? Let us find out. B. Rub a refill and place it gently in a glass tumbler as before. Bring an inflated charged balloon near the refill and observe. Let's summarize the observation. A charged balloon repelled a charged ball. A charged refill replaced a charged refill, but a charged balloon attracted a charged refill. Does it indicate that the charge on the balloon is of a different kind from the charge on the refill? Can we say then that there are two kinds of charges? Can we also say that the charges of the same kind repel each other, while charges of different kinds attract each other? It is a convenience to call the charge acquired by a glass rod when it is rubbed with silk as positivity. The other kind of charge is said to be negative. It is observed that when a charged glass rod is brought near a charged plastic straw rubbed with polythene, there is attraction between the two. What do you think would be the kind of charge on the plastic straw? Your guess that the plastic straw will carry a negative charge is correct. The electric charge generated by rubbing and are static. They do not move by themselves. When charge move, they constitute an electric current. You have been reading about electric current since class 6. The current in a circuit which makes a bulb glow or the current that makes a wire hot is nothing but a motion of charges. 15.4. Transfer of charge. Activity 15.4. Take an empty jam bottle. Take a piece of cardboard slightly bigger in size than the mouth of the bottle. Pierce a hole in it so that a metal paper can be inserted. Open out the paper clip as shown in Fig. 15.4. Cut two strips of aluminium foil about 4 cm into 1 cm each. Hang them on the paper clip as shown. Insert the paper clip in the cardboard lid so that it is perpendicular to it. Charge refill and touch it with the end of the paper clip. Observe what happens. Is there any effect on the foil strips? Do they repel each other or attract each other? Now touch other charged body with the end of the paper clip. Do not foil strips behave in the same way in all cases? Can this apparatus be used to detect whether a body is charged or not? Can you explain why the foil strip repel each other? The aluminium foil strips receive the same charge from the charged bill through the paper clip. The strips carrying similar charges repel each other and they become wide open. Such a device can be used to test whether an object is carrying charge or not. This device is known as electroscope. Thus, we find that electrical charge can be transferred from a charged object to another through a metal conductor. Touch the end of the paper clip gently with hand and you will find a change in the foil strips. They become back to their original state. Repeat charging of foil strips and touch the paper clip. Every strips and are touching the paper clip. Every time you will find that the foil strips collapse as soon as you touch the paper clip with hand. Why does it happen? The reason is that the foil strips lose charge to the earth through your body. We say that the foil strips are discharged. The process of transferring of charge from a charged object into the earth is called earthing. 15.5. The story of lightning. It is now possible to explain lightning in terms of charges produced by rubbing. You learnt in class 7 that during the development of the thunderstorm, the air current move upwards while the water droplets move downwards. These various movements cause separation of charges by a process not yet completely understood. The positive charges collect near the upper edges of the clouds and the negative charges accumulate near the lower edges. There is accumulation of positive charges near the ground also. When the magnitude and the accumulated charges become very, very large, the air, which is normally a poor conductor of electricity, is no longer able to resist their flow. Negative and positive charges meet, producing streaks of bright light and sound. We see streams as lightning. The process is called an electric charges discharge. The process of electric discharge can occur between two or more clouds or between clouds and the earth. Today, we need not get frightened by lightning like our ancestors did. Now we understood trying hard to improve this understanding. However, lightning strike cloud destroy life and property. It is therefore necessary to take measures to protect ourselves. 15.6. Lightning safety. During lightning and thunderstorm, no open place is safe. Hearing thunder is an alert to rush to a safe place. After hearing the last thunder, wait for some time before coming out of the safe place. Finding a safe place. If house or building is a safe place. If you are traveling by car or by bus, you are safe inside with windows and doors of the vehicle shut. Do and don'ts during a thunderstorm. Outside, open vehicles like motorbikes, tractors, construction machinery, open cars and are not safe. Open wheels, tall trees, shields and parks, elevated places do not protect as from lightning strokes. Carrying an umbrella is not at all a good idea during thunderstorm. If in a forest, take shelter under shelter tree. If no shelter is available and you are in a open field, stay far away from the trees. Stay away from poles or other metal objects. Do not lie on the ground. Instead, squat low on the ground. Place your hands on the knees with your head between the hands. This position will make you the smallest target to be struck. Inside the house, lightning can strike telephone cords, electrical wires and metal pipes. Remember, lightning is an electrical discharge. During a thunderstorm, contact with this should be avoided. It is not safer to use mobile phones and cordless phones. However, it is not wise to call up a person who is receiving your phone through a wire phone. Bathing should be avoided during thunderstorms to avoid contact with running water. Electrical appliances like computer, TVs, etc. should be unplugged. Electrical lights can remain on. They do not cause any harm. Lightning conductors. Lightning conductor is a device used to protect buildings from the effect of lightning. A metallic rod taller than the building is installed in the walls of the building during its construction. One of the end of the rod is kept out in the air and the other is buried deep in the ground. The rod provides easy route for the transfer of electricity charges to the ground. The metal columns used during construction, electrical wires and water pipes in the buildings also protect us to an extent, but do not touch them during a thunderstorm. 15.7 Earthquake. Just learned about thunderstorm and lightning. In class 7, you learned about cyclones. This natural phenomenon can cause large-scale destruction of human life and property. Fortunately, this phenomena can be predicted to some extent. The weather department can warn about a thunderstorm developing in some area. If a thunderstorm occurs, there is always a possibility of lightning and cyclone upon a company of it. So we get time to take measures to protect ourselves from the damage caused by this phenomena. There is, however, one natural phenomenon which we are not yet able to predict accurately. It is an earthquake. It can cause damage to human life and property on a huge scale. A major earthquake occurs in India on October 8, 2005 in Uri and Tangadhar towns of North Kashmir. Before that, a major earthquake occurred on 26 January 2001 in Bhuj district of Gujarat. Activity 15.5. Ask your parents about the huge damage to life and property caused by the earthquakes. Collect a few pictures showing the damage caused by these earthquakes from newspapers and magazines of those days. Prepare a short report on the suffering of the people after the earthquakes. What is an earthquake? What happens when it occurs? What can we do to minimize its effect? These are some of the questions which we shall discuss below. What is an earthquake? An earthquake is a sudden shaking or trembling of the earth which lasts for a very short time. It is caused by a disturbance deep inside the earth's crust. Earthquakes occur all the time over the earth. They are not even noticed. Major earthquakes are much less frequent. They can cause immense damage to buildings, bridges, dams and peoples. There can be a great loss to life and property. Earthquakes can cause floods, landslides and tsunamis. A major tsunami occurred in the India Ocean on 26 December 2004. All the coastal areas around the ocean suffered huge loss. Activity 15.6. Take out an outline map of the world. Locate the eastern coast and Andaman and Nicobar Island in India. Mark other countries around the Indian Ocean which would have suffered damage. Collect account of the devastation caused by the tsunami in India from your parents or other elders in the family or in the neighbors? What causes an earthquake? In ancient times, people did not know the true cause of earthquake. Their ideas were therefore expressed in mythical stories such as the one told by Bujo's grandmother. Similarly, myths were prevalent in other parts of the world. Now we know that the tremors are caused by the disturbance deep down inside the uppermost layer of the earth called the crust. The outermost layer of the earth is not in one piece. It is fragmented. Each fragment is called a plate. These plates are in continual motion. When they brush past one another or a plate goes under another due to a collision, they cause disturbance in the earth's crust. It is this disturbance that shows up as an earthquake on the surface of the earth. Although we know that for sure what causes an earthquake, it is not yet possible to predict when and where the next earthquake might occur. Tremors on the earth can also be caused when a volcano erupts or a meteor hits the earth or an undergoes ground nuclear explosion is carried out. However, most earthquakes are caused by the movement of the earth's plate. Since earthquakes are caused by the movement of plates, the boundaries of the plates are the weak stones, whereas earthquakes are more likely to occur. The weak zones are also known as seismic or fault zones. In India, the area most threatened are Kashmir, western and central Himalayas, the whole of northeast range of Kutch, Rajasthan and the Indo-Gangetic plate. Some areas of South India also falls in the danger zone. The power of an earthquake is expressed in terms of a magnitude on a scale called the Richter scale. Recall, really destructive earthquakes have magnitude higher than 7 on the Richter scale. Both Bhuj and Kashmir earthquakes had magnitudes greater than 7.5. Protection against earthquake. You know from the earlier pages that earthquake cannot be predicted. We have also seen that they can be highly destructive. It is therefore important that we take necessary precaution to protect ourselves all the time. People living in the seismic zones where the earthquakes are more likely to occur have to be specially prepared. First of all, the buildings in this zone should be designed so that they can withstand major tremors. Modern buildings technology can make it possible. It is advisable to make the structure simple so that it is quake safe. Consult qualified architects and structural engineers. In highly seismic areas, the use of mud or timber is better than using heavy construction material. Keep roofs as light as possible. In case the structure falls, the damage will not be heavy. It is better if the cupboards and shelves are fixed to the wall so that they do not fall easily. Be careful where you hang wall clocks, photo frames, water heaters, etc. so that the event of an earthquake, they do not fall on people. Since some buildings may catch fire due to an earthquake, it is necessary that all buildings, especially tall buildings, have fire fighting equipment in working order. The Central Building Research Institute's Ruki has developed know-how to make quake resistance house. In the event of that an earthquake does strike, that take the following steps to protect yourself. If you are at home, take shelter under a table and stay there till the shaking stops. Stay away from tall and heavy objects that may fall on you. If you are in bed, do not get up. Protect your head with pillow. If you are outdoors, find a clear spot away from buildings, trees and overhead power lines. Drop to the ground. If you are in a car or a bus, do not come out. Ask the driver to drive slowly to a clear spot. Do not come out till the tremors stop.